guys, Robert Eilweiss from O'Brien Real Estate Brighton. Checking again with the 12th edition of the Bayside Property News for 2021, where real estate information is on the house. Since the Melbourne cut interest rate cut to 10 basis points, all asset classes have increased in the line correlation. The media suggesting real estate is rising more than any other asset classes. Shares have risen similar, and so too have commodity prices for oil and iron ore machinery. And even a depreciation asset like cars are up 30% from 12 months ago. A recent market update from ANZ on home price predictions puts Melbourne house prices at a 16% increase this year and 6% next year, with ANZ stating they believe AFRA may put the brakes on letting availability to prevent unsustainable growth in the medium term. Last week, CoreLogic data showed nationally house prices have recovered to a record highs last month. Now that is after dropping 11.1% over 2017 to 2019 and 5.6% over 2020. Let's take a quick look at the numbers over the week. Auctions across Victoria remained strong at 87% clearance rate for last weekend, with 596 auctions selling. Private sales reported across Victoria was a healthy 1,452 sales.
Looking at O'Brien Real Estate, over the Easter school holidays, we have seen expected lower listings and sales numbers across the group, with 66 new listings hitting the market, with 68 properties going under offer and 61 confirmed sales and a top price of $1.2 million.
Here are the new edits making the headlines this week. Last week reported on the competitive job market. The National Skills Commission reported vacancies for jobs is at a 12-year high, job ads at 96.4% from 12 months ago. Seven companies floated on the ASX this week. In fact, 2021 looks to be a very busy year for the company floats on the stock market, with bullish investment confidence. Solid figures are due to be coming out of the China later this week, with data on GDP, trade and retail spending, production and investment, which will be assist to further worldwide economic recovery. Finally, US share market keeps rising, hit another all-time high last Friday, with the latest inflation numbers building confidence in the market. That's all for the week. I'm Robert Eilweiss. Remember, the information provided is of a general nature. You should always seek independent legal, financial and taxation advice to your unique circumstances. I'm Robert Eilweiss. Bye for now.